There she goes on a wing and away, and a wing and away, and away she goes. There she goes on a wing and away, and away, on a wing she goes.
Stories are encouraged in children, but adults don't really get encouraged to plan how to tell a story and to invest the time in telling the story. And I think the Blue Metropolis Foundation wanted to see what would come up if we mined the stories, local stories and true stories and made up stories of adults in the English community in Quebec. We're going to tell a story together, one word at a time. So I'll start. Once
upon
a time.
The first day is about getting comfortable. Some of the people I know already have quite a lot of experience with storytelling, and some people will have had none at all. But all of them will have a genuine interest.
Morning.
Well, I dreamt I was floating on driftwood. Words were floating on my tongue, and I aim for that place with a wonder.
Getting ready to write.
Yeah, getting ready to write. I'm writing up a storm.
By using a bunch of different exercises, I have found that something always appeals to someone. Some people respond more to really technical things like word cluster work and really structured exercises. Some people prefer taking it off the page and game-like exercises.
On this side, I just want you to write some random nouns. So then on the other side, I want you to think of an occupation, and I want you to write words that come to your mind when you think of that. Now, what you're gonna do is take your combinations. And you just want to write a poem that uses these words that you didn't mean to put together?
Cat's paws in the sink, bones of cold, ice pellets retract the muscle, purple bike carving an OG molding, perfumed flower exits the nail gun.
That is so deep.
Yeah.
Glee sharpened the building so that clouds had a taste and tomorrow boiled like ice. Houses sliced the smoke and sautéed the lake.
Wow.
Nice.
I was involved in several storytelling groups in Montreal, and I found that the stories were more based on fancy or on concepts or on other things that we had read or seen. But I find in the country, the stories kind of grow out of the place. My friends in the country who are storytellers, they tend to look to the location, to the landscape, to the people, the old-timers.
In this exercise, we're going to describe a place. We all know how to make a word cluster. It's just to unlock some descriptive words that you're going to be able to use when you write about that place. Then you've got a whole vocabulary on that page that talks about your feelings about the thing, which is great.
Everybody has their cœur du village. For me and many others, it is Café Molo. Two young women said, I know, let's open a little coffee shop. Not a shiny, chrome and steamy Starbucks-type coffee shop, but a babies and geezers, logs in the stove, secondhand clothes upstairs, slightly grungy toilets kind of coffee shop. And lo, the people came and saw that it was just what they were looking for.
Nice.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Mine is about my house, my home, which I bought a year and a half ago when I moved back to Wakefield. This home, my very own. Sorry. I get really emotional for some reason.
That's okay. It's good.
What's in your coffee?
Sugar. The view is nature's window to the world. So much green and silence. If there's music, it's what I want to hear. read it. It's terrible.
It's good. It's really good.
There is truth lying hidden beneath the blankets. My soul is here waiting to be discovered. When I walk in the woods in sandals and boots or snowshoes, I stop every few steps and listen. I stop and feel the wind, watch the deer and the rocks in their unmoving state, and I imagine their consciousness, their wild history, the energy of every living being that has ever passed them by. And I wonder at the magic of this place and what drew us together. Angels, I think. The timing is always, is, was perfect. And the place, as always, is perfect, for now at least.
From the early Romans through the gypsies to modern literature to film, the stories that we listen to inform us and empower us to act. It's a bit like a practice for life.
And here's the elements of a good story. Character, yes, but an interesting one. Desire, conflict. The more they want something, the more juicy the conflict can be. Change. Because the character changes or the narrator changes, the reader's opinion changes. And then the fifth thing is really, to me, the craft of writing. Sensually precise language. We get better as we write, so we just have to write. So I would like you to write about one of your grandparents and how something about them made you who you are today.
And this is the longest night I've spent alone.
But even as I asked myself, which grandparent will I write about, I already knew I had to write about Oma, my German grandma. And the horrible thing is, all my life, she is known as a legend in Sutton, a wonderful woman, a strong woman. But it was really painful as I was writing, because I realized I didn't like her. But I would need you to read it. Mm-hmm. I'm too emotionally attached to it.
Oma. People said it with reverence. A woman who braved the Depression and lived on turnips and potatoes for a whole year. A woman who made it when no one else could. A woman who bought a 150-acre farm with her new husband and made it work when no one else could. Then why didn't I like her? Maybe it was because a typical conversation with my grandmother went something like this. Kathy, run up to the chalet and get me some flour for my cake. Kathy, clean up this kitchen while I put the bread in the oven. Did you say your prayers today? Have you been to church? I'm going to pray for you and your sisters and brother. I'd hide in my room whenever I knew she was downstairs. I'd sneak out of the house to escape her. My wonderful grandmother, my Oma. And then she got older. And she went into an old age home. And I didn't visit her much and I felt guilty. And then she died. And I didn't cry. Sometimes I stand back and listen to myself as I rant. Miles, pick up your school bag. Laura, can you set the table? Olivia, you haven't taken your shower yet. How many times have I asked you? And then I'm confused because I don't know if I'm just being a mom or if I'm turning into my grandmother. And one day my children will hide away from me.
Time passes, everything changes.
We don't have enough people telling our own stories. I think this is exactly what our community needs.
All those amazing pictures out there, I think that we should all just find a character in one of the pictures. You're going to just use them as a jumping off point.
These words I overheard while holding his photo in my hand. Dappled sunlight, how when they were young, were welcomed in with open arms.
If you look carefully, there's a kid that's inside still, looking out of the window.
Whoa!
So I did it from the plot. It's so unfair. They're all outside, everyone wearing their Sunday best, but still wrapped against the cold. Ma washed my best pinafore and pressed it specially for this morning, but now I can only watch through the window. I hate Miss Evans. She's a witch. Just because I can't ever remember my 7x table. Now no one will ever remember me. I'm not even in the photograph.
I would like people to remember that storytelling is for everyone. You don't have to be a performer to tell a story. Your stories and your family stories and your history belong to you.
My dad was working on the building of landing crafts for troops. Mother stayed at home, and besides rationing, money was scarce. Candies, or sweets as we call them, were a luxury. At the top of our road were several shops, one of them a greengrocer and owned by Mr. Walton. It must have been about 1944 when word got round that Mr. Walton was giving away to children a bag of sweet chocolate powder. If it had all gone by the time I got there, I knew I would feel brokenhearted. I was told it was a gift from Canada. I knew nothing about Canada. In fact, at that time, no local children knew very much about the outside world, except, of course, Germany. I wondered if Canada grew cocoa. Mr. Wharton gave me my bag of sweet chocolate powder, and strolling back home, I opened the bag, and out wafted the most beautiful smell of chocolate. It was the best thing I had ever tasted, and I was in ecstasy. I will always remember that special day in my young life, and I suspect the Canadians responsible for such a gift could never have imagined just how much joy the sweet chocolate powder would bring to the children of England. Thank you, Canada.
The taste of the chocolate. That got me. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I actually tasted the chocolate. Yeah.
It's very bizarre that we should leave stories unexamined. In fact, we should be thinking about them a lot more. Not only that, but in terms of our history and our ancestors, very often all we have left of them are stories.
Felton died. It was late summer after his 12th birthday, and he was riding his bike down the farm lane, heading to help his father and Harry with some chores. His bike hit a small rock in the lane, and Felton tumbled down the handlebar, striking his abdomen. That's all it took for his appendix. Felton was curled up in a ball and was carried to the house. Before the doctor could even arrive, Felton's eyes closed for the last time with his mother at his side. His father's heart broke with Felton's last breath, and he threw himself into his work. Felton's father had started emptying the fields of their stones to redo the house. The house was soon done. However, when he was finished, the restlessness remained. His son, his happy little boy, was still gone. He wanted him home. After long, sleepless nights, it finally hit him. He'd bring home to his son. Later that afternoon, Ella stood in the same place she was the night before. She once more placed her hand on the stones of the wall, the stones that had been plucked from Stone Valley's fields years before. They now hugged the hillside cemetery. Tears filled her eyes as she felt the last protective embrace a father could give to his son.
Nicely done.
My favorite quote is from a very famous Irish storyteller, and it is that if you don't use your power, it will desert you for someone who will.
The shingles on a wing and away, on a wing and away, and away she goes. The shingles on a wing and away, and away, on a wing she goes. Shine like the stars, how sweet am I.
An awakening for myself. It's given me more confidence and inspired me to write more. So I guess that was the goal.
The end.